So now we are going to start the continuation of our human excretory system, the structure of nephron. As I said already, it also including in your human excretory system and the structure of nephron. So nephrons is otherwise called as uriniferous tubules. Is the structural and functional unit of the kidney. As I said, the human cell will be the structural and functional unit of the whole human body. Likewise, the structure of nephron, that is, the nephron is the structural and functional unit of the kidney. The kidney is made up of nephron. Okay, so each nephrons consist of renal corpuscle or Malpighian corpuscle. So renal corpuscle is nothing but it is a blood filtering component which is present in the kidney. It is used for purifying your blood. Okay, and also it consists of renal tubules. So renal tubule, it is a kidney tube, is called as renal tubule. As I said, renal is represented as kidney. So each kidney consists of more than 1 millions of nephrons. So a single kidney is made of 1 millions of nephrons, 1 millions of kidney cell. Okay. Then the renal corpuscle consists of a cup shaped structure called the Bowman's capsule. This is the Bowman's capsule. This is looking like a cup. This is called as Bowman's capsule. Now the Bowman's capsule containing a bunch of capillaries called glomerulus. So these are the bunch of blood capillaries. Okay, the Bowman's capsule is composed of bunch of blood capillaries, and that is called as glomerulus. This is the blood capillaries through which the blood is entering into your kidney. It is entering through the afferent arteriole. Your blood from the body, blood to kidney, it is entering through the afferent arterioles, and the blood is getting out through efferent arterioles. Okay, it is getting in through afferent arteriole and it is getting out through efferent arteriole. Then the Bowman's capsule is not ending with a cup, it also extending like a tubules. Okay, so look at this picture. The Bowman's capsule is continuing as a tubules. Okay, it consists of three stages. Okay, so the first region is proximal convoluted tubule, and the second region is loop of Hennel. It is looking like a hairpin, like U-shaped hairpin. Okay, it is called as loop of Hennel, and the third region is distal convoluted tubule. Proximal convoluted tubule, loop of Hennel, then the distal convoluted tubule. Okay, then the distal convoluted tubule is then opening into the collecting tubule. The straight tube is called as collecting tubule. This is the pathway for the purification of your blood. Okay, in each place, each kind of purification is taken place. So the blood is entering through the afferent arteriole and it is getting out through the efferent arteriole. And there are three stages of your Bowman's capsule is connecting into three different stages. Then the last stage, the distal convoluted tubule, is connecting to the collecting tubule. Okay, here the nitrogenous waste are drained into renal pelvis, which is leading to your ureter. This is the ureter. This is leading to your ureter. Okay, so through the ureter, the urine is stored in the urinary bladder and the urine is expelled out through urethra. Okay, then the mechanism of urine formation. So the process of urine formation includes the following three stages: glomerular filtration, tubular reabsorption, tubular secretion. Okay, through the glomerular filtration, tubular reabsorption, tubular secretion. These are the three stages which is taken in your nephron, as we already saw the stages of nephron, right? So, and each stage, what kind of filtration is going on? Okay, we'll see what kind of filtration is going on each stages. The first one is glomerular filtration. So here the urine formation is beginning. Here the filtration of blood through the epithelial walls. So in the last lesson we studied about the epithelial tissues. It is like a tissue paper. Okay, here the filtration of blood is taken place in the walls of glomerulus and Bowman's capsule. This is glomerulus and this is called as the Bowman's capsule. Here, from here the blood is entering in. Here the filtration has started. Here both essential and non-essential substances which is present in the blood are also filtered. Okay, the essential, also the non-essential substances are also filtered. Then tubular reabsorption. This is the tubular one. Tubular reabsorption. The filtrate, as I show you, the proximal convoluted tubule is starting here, right? So through this, it is the essential substances such as glucose, amino acids, vitamins, sodium, potassium, bicarbonates and water. Okay, as I said, you told you already, in glomerular filtration the essential substances are also filtered. Now the essential substances has to be replaced. Okay, it should be reabsorbed in the proximal tubule. The reabsorption taken place. So here through the proximal convoluted tubule the reabsorption is taken place. This process called as selective reabsorption. It is selectively reabsorbing. Okay. Then tubular secretion. So substances like hydrogen and or potassium ions are secreted in the tubules. That are the unwanted substances. Here in the collecting tubule, hydrogen and potassium are secreted. This filtrate is finally known as urine. Okay, then which is hypertonic in man. So what is meant by hypertonic? Which contains the high content of your hydrogen or potassium ions. Highly concentrated one is called as hypertonic. So finally, the urine is now entering into the collecting tubule. Okay, through it is for entering into the urinary bladder through the urethra. When the urinary bladder is full, it should be expelled out, right? So when the urinary bladder is full, the urine is expelled out through the urethra. This process is called as micturition. As I told you already, when the urinary bladder is full, we have to expel out the urine. Such process is called as micturition. A healthy person excretes 1 to 2 liters of urine per day, right? We should be very healthy. So that drink 8 glasses of water per day. Okay, 3 liters of water you have to drink. 3 liters of water daily. That is 8 glasses of water. Drink plenty of water makes a man healthy. Okay, you could lead a happy and healthier life. Then this is the route of urine flow. So far we have studied about how the urine is produced by the blood filtration. This is the simple stages flowchart of urine filtration. This is glomerulus. Here the ultrafiltration is done. Then the urine is entering into the Bowman's capsule. Here the glomerulus filtrate, that is called as glomerular filtrate. Then proximal convoluted tubule. Here the water, glucose, sodium and chloride ions are getting reabsorbed. Then it is entering into the loop of Hennel. Here the absorption of water and sodium ions are taken place. Then to the distal convoluted tubules. Here the chloride and waters are getting reabsorbed. Then the collecting tubule. Then the urine is entering into the collecting duct. Okay, it is where the urine is stored. Then ureter, through the ureter it is entering into the urethra. Okay, urinary bladder. Then urinary bladder is excreting out your urethra. Then dialysis or artificial kidney. When the kidney lose their filtering efficiency, so kidney has to clean our body, right? So when kidney has losing their ability, the excessive amount of toxic substances will be accumulated in the body. Okay, this condition is known as kidney failure. For this, an artificial kidney is used to filter the blood of a patient. The patient is said to be put on dialysis, and the process of purifying blood by an artificial kidney is called as hemodialysis. So the blood is purifying to get the urine. Okay, so in some person the kidney will be unable to perform their day-to-day activities. For that, the artificial kidneys have to be replaced to perform their to clean their body. Okay, the process of purifying blood by an artificial kidney is called as hemodialysis. When kidney failure cannot be treated by drug or dialysis, the patients are advised for kidney transplantation, that is organ transplantation. I think you might have heard about organ transplantation. When a healthy person failed, like this kidney failure, or they have some heart problems or some other organ problems, they have a ability to replace them. Okay, replace from the dead person. Then do you know, we are here to know some facts. The two healthy kidneys contains a total of about 2 million nephrons. So as I said, each kidney is composed of 1 million of nephron. So the two kidneys is made of 2 million of nephron. They have a ability to filter 1700 to 1800 liters of blood. So the kidney has the ability to reabsorb, also the redistribute. Here the 99% of the blood volume is purified and only 1% of the blood is filtered, and that is becoming the urine. Okay. The first kidney transplantation. In 1954, Joseph E. Murray and his colleagues at Peter Ben Brink Hospital in Boston, USA, performed the first successful kidney transplant between Ronald and Richard Herrick, who were identical twins. What is meant by identical twins? Those who are cannot be identified is called as identical twins. The recipient Richard Herrick died after 8 years of transplantation. Okay. So the organ transplantation, this is the very first organ transplantation done in the world, okay, which is done by Joseph E. Murray and his colleague at USA. Okay. Thank you, students.